My name is Robin Bowman. I'm the director of Lurie Children's Multidisciplinary Spina Bifida Center and a fetal neurosurgeon with the Chicago Institute for Fetal Health, one of the few comprehensive fetal care centers in the country. Approximately 1,500 babies are born each year in the United States with open spina bifida. In many cases, our experienced team can repair this birth defect while the baby is in the womb. This video demonstrates our minimally invasive fetoscopic repair for open spina bifida. This technique is designed to reduce the risk for mother and baby undergoing fetal surgery while preserving the option of vaginal delivery. Babies with open spina bifida who underwent back closure before birth have been shown to have long-term an improvement in their leg function, less of a need for hydrocephalus treatment, and improvement in the imaging of their brain. Open spina bifida occurs when the bones of a baby's back do not close properly. The baby's spinal cord extends through the open bones and attaches to the skin. This birth defect most often occurs in the baby's lower back region. Open spina bifida also has an impact on the developing brain. Babies with open spina bifida may develop an excess of spinal fluid known as hydrocephalus. The back part of their brain may also sink down into the neck, and this is known as hindbrain herniation. Fetal closure of the exposed spinal cord has been shown to help improve the hindbrain herniation and decrease the development of excessive brain water. The repair of an open spina bifida is done before 26 weeks gestation. Let's walk through this procedure. Once the mother is prepared for surgery and under anesthesia, we create an incision on her abdomen. A transverse or horizontal incision is made across the lower abdomen. In some cases, a midline incision is made. The abdominal muscles are then opened in the midline, the abdominal cavity is entered, and the uterus is exposed. Intraoperative ultrasound is used to precisely identify the position of the baby and the placenta, which helps us plan our entry points. While watching with the ultrasound, the initial port is inserted into the uterus. Warm, humidified carbon dioxide is then infused into the uterine cavity to expand our working field. We then insert a camera through the port and watch on the viewing screen as two additional 3 mm ports are inserted into the uterus. After all three ports are inserted, the fetus is anesthetized and the back closure begins. We begin by releasing the spinal cord from the surrounding tissues. This allows the cord to relax back within the canal, and we then close the spinal cord with a few stitches. Our attention is then turned to the dura, or the tough membrane covering the brain and spinal cord, which holds in the spinal fluid. The dura is freed circumferentially and closed in a watertight fashion. Lastly, the skin is undermined and closed in the midline. Occasionally, the defect is too large to allow primary skin closure. In this situation, a patch is used to close the skin opening. The fetal repair portion of the procedure is now complete. To further protect the baby for the duration of pregnancy, warm fluid and antibiotics are placed within the uterine cavity. All ports are removed and the incisions are sutured closed. The mother's abdominal wall and skin are closed. The fetus continues to develop and heal for the duration of the pregnancy. During this time, the hindbrain herniation may also correct itself, as the cerebellum will likely move back into place. Ideally, the pregnancy continues to full term, at which point the baby is delivered vaginally and cared for by our expert team of specialists. The Chicago Institute for Fetal Health and Lurie Children's Hospital is home to one of the oldest and largest multidisciplinary spina bifida centers in the world. The spina bifida team is comprised of a variety of surgical, medical, and rehabilitation experts who are focused on assisting each child with open spina bifida reach and maintain their highest developmental potential. The Chicago Institute for Fetal Health team will ensure you and your baby's care is individualized and thorough throughout your child's life.